Hello and welcome to the first WION Live Broadcast from London of 2022. Happy New Year. I'm Ollie Barrett. Let's take a look at the top headlines this hour. The United States has recorded over a million COVID-19 cases in the last 24 hours, according to Johns Hopkins University. That sets a global record of a single day spike in COVID infections. President Joe Biden and Donald Trump look set to address the nation simultaneously on the first anniversary of the Capitol Hill riots later this week. It's being called a split-screen moment in the United States, highlighting, again, deep divisions in the country. Continuing with its zero COVID approach, China puts the city of Jeju, with over a million residents, into lockdown over three virus cases. India's national capital, Delhi, imposes a weekend curfew to try and curb the spread of the Omicron variant of the coronavirus. Cases have risen in the past few days. The Sri Lankan cabinet has granted approval to develop 61 tanks at Trinco oil tank farm through a joint venture between Lankan and Indian oil companies. We'll start in the UK, where Omicron infections continue to surge, and there are warnings of growing pressure on hospitals and also the education sector as schools return. And while Scotland, Wales and Northern Ireland did impose some toughened measures to kick in after Christmas, Prime Minister Boris Johnson in England is still resisting new curbs.
The way forward for the country as a whole is to continue with the path that we're on. We'll keep everything under review. Of course, we keep all measures under review. But the mixture of things that we're doing at the moment is, I think, the right one. So, number one, continue with plan B. Make sure that people take it seriously. Do what we can to stop the spread. Use the plan B measures. Work from home if you can. Wear a mask on public transport. Be sensible about, take a test before going out to meet people you don't normally meet. Think about the requirements under Plan B, but also get the booster.
Boris Johnson says evidence is showing Omicron to be plainly milder, that's how he describes it, than earlier forms of the virus. But here resuming with our look at the state of play when it comes to Omicron in England, the country imposed limited measures known as Plan B last month. Those measures include the wearing of face coverings on public transport and in shops, but the government stopped short of ordering restrictions to close businesses or restrict numbers at gatherings. When Boris Johnson was asked whether the UK should follow the United States in reducing the duration of isolation for positive cases, he said Britain would continue to study the infectivity period, but stressed current measures were effective for the country. And we can go live to our London correspondent, Laura Makin-Isherwood, who's joining us now. And Laura, is it fair to say that at this point after Christmas, it's actually looking less likely that the government in England will tighten COVID restrictions over the Omicron variant?
Well, it seems so. And despite another huge number of COVID-19 infections being recorded on Monday, more than 150,000 in just a 24-hour period, it seems like that volume of cases is not translating into hospitalizations, or at least in the numbers that would have been expected this time last year. In fact, the number of people in hospital are currently lower than 12 months ago. And also, the evidence so far seems to suggest that even those that are hospitalized will actually remain under health professionals' care for a shorter time period, and they're less likely to need critical care. But of course, health bosses are still concerned that because of the sheer volume of COVID-19 cases that are continually being reported day on day, that even though the risk might be less severe, those numbers actually could still overwhelm the NHS, particularly when the National Health Service itself is also suffering from a bit of a staff shortage at the moment, with the volume of health workers and others that are on the front line of healthcare sectors also being off in isolation because they have contracted COVID-19 as well. However, the Prime Minister, Boris Johnson, is simply saying that he's looking at the data now. And when it comes to putting in new restrictions, it doesn't seem likely because, as those UK and South Africa studies suggest, the Omicron variant of COVID-19 might actually lead to a less severe illness than previous variants. And also, he's looking at this sort of isolation period when you do get COVID-19 as well. And at the moment, they seem to be sticking to that 7-day period, not following the United States at the moment. Those extra 2 days that people are being asked to remain away from others might actually give an extra buffer period, scientists think, to try to prevent that spread of the virus even further. And so the Plan B measures that are in place across England, at least here, working from home where possible, wearing masks in certain situations, and of course, combining that with that 7-day isolation period, ministers are hoping will be enough to keep this spread contained and prevent people going into hospital.
Okay, Laura, thank you. That's Laura Macon-Isherwood in London for us. As experts continue to look into the merits and efficacy of a fourth COVID vaccine dose, the head of Britain's vaccine body is suggesting a fourth jab should not be offered until there are Chairman of the UK's Joint Committee on Vaccination and Immunisation, Professor Sir Andrew Pollard, said authorities need to target only the vulnerable rather than giving further boosters to all. And he insisted that giving boosters to people every 6 months is not sustainable, he said. Sir Andrew also says there is no point in trying to stop all infections as mutant variants will continue to emerge. The Department of Health reported a further 157,700 cases on Monday, which is a rise of nearly 44.6% since last week, although comparisons are difficult because of the holiday period. Next to France, where lawmakers have debated draft legislation that would require most people to be vaccinated against COVID-19. The pass would be required to enter public spaces such as bars, restaurants and long-distance public transport. The new law would remove the option of showing a negative test result instead of having the jabs. Dubbed the vaccine pass, the bill's headline measure is aimed at getting France's remaining 5 million unvaccinated people over 12 to accept a shot. It has the backing of several parties and looks set to be passed by the lower house. The debate in the French Parliament highlighted what the government and the opposition describe as widespread fatigue with the pandemic and measures to tackle it. The proposed tightening of the rules angered anti-vaccination activists.
L'ordre du jour appelle la discussion.
Oui, le temps de mes 8 minutes de prose. Madame la Présidente, depuis plusieurs semaines, Nous attendions avec impatience des fêtes de fin d'année, synonymes de repos. Ne perdons pas de vue que l'objectif de ce texte de loi n'est pas de contraindre les libertés individuelles et collectives des Français. L'objectif de ce texte de loi, c'est de sauver des vies, c'est de protéger nos hôpitaux, de soulager la charge de travail de nos soignants.
Moving on to updates coming in from the United States, hospitalizations are on the rise. The country is expanding its COVID-19 boosters approach as well, this time to children as young as 12. While boosters are already recommended for everyone 16 years and above, the U.S. Food and Drug Administration has now authorized the use of a third dose of the Pfizer-BioNTech COVID-19 jab for children 12 to 15 years old. The booster dose was also approved for immunocompromised children between the ages of 5 and 11. The FDA also narrowed down the interval for the booster shot from 6 months to 5. The decision also comes as school children return by the millions to classrooms following their winter holidays.
I want to get vaccinated because it's way better and less chances of getting COVID. And I really don't want to get COVID, so I'm really happy that I'm getting it.
It's not the very same to receive the remote school lessons. That is not helping anyone, so the more they get vaccinated, they will continue their school lessons as usual, and that's the best for everyone.
The FDA said that it relied on data from Israel when making that decision, where thousands of children between 12 to 15 have already received the booster dose. Over 4.1 million people 16 and above also got their booster shots after 5 months of getting fully vaccinated, and no new safety concerns have emerged. The U.S. Centers for Disease Control and Prevention, meanwhile, is expected to give its final approval to these decisions in the coming days. The U.S. is currently averaging about 400,000 fresh COVID-19 cases each day, a record high since the pandemic started 2 years ago. Hospitalizations have also increased. According to the latest data from the U.S. Department of Health, over 100,000 people are currently hospitalized with the infection for the first time in nearly 4 months. Also worrying is that hospitalizations of children infected with COVID-19 is also on the rise. So far, 62% of the American population has been fully vaccinated, and a third of them have also received the booster shot. Moving on for now, on the 3rd of January, Mexican President Andrés Manuel López Obrador had renewed his offer of asylum to the WikiLeaks founder Julian Assange. This comes after the Mexican leader earlier attempted to convince former U.S. President Donald Trump to pardon Julian Assange last year. Assange, who founded WikiLeaks in the year 2006, moved closer to facing criminal charges in the United States for one of the biggest leaks of classified information and rattling governments by leaking sensitive facts. And last month, Washington won an appeal over Assange's extradition to the United States to face espionage charges. U.S. authorities have accused the 50-year-old WikiLeaks founder of 18 counts, which includes WikiLeaks' release of vast troves of confidential U.S. military records and diplomatic cables in violation of the Espionage Act, which, according to officials, had put scores of lives in danger. Meanwhile, reiterating to offer asylum to Assange, Mexican President Obrador said that he had written a letter to former U.S. President Donald Trump recommending that the WikiLeaks founder should be pardoned. However, according to the Mexican leader, Mexico did not receive any response to the letter.
Terminara la administración del presidente Donald Trump, yo le envié un escrito pidiéndole que se le exonerara, se le perdonara. Ya ven que a finales de los gobiernos en Estados Unidos pueden los presidentes hacer uso de esta facultad. Pues envié esa carta. No tuvo respuesta.
López Obrador is of the opinion that if Assange is granted asylum in Mexico, then he will not be able to interfere in the affairs of other countries and will not represent any kind of threat.
Que el gobierno de Estados Unidos debe actuar con humanismo. Assange está enfermo y sería una muestra de solidaridad, de fraternidad, el permitirle que recibiera asilo en el país que Assange resolviera vivir.
Meanwhile, a slew of hurdles remain for Julian Assange, who could be sent to the United States after an odyssey that has taken him from a teenage hacker in Melbourne to years hold up in the Ecuadorian embassy in London. And supporters of the 50-year-old Assange cast him as an anti-establishment hero who has been persecuted by the United States for exposing America's wrongdoings. Eco-tourism is the new catchphrase of our times, but what exactly does this mean? Eco-tourism is sustainable and responsible tourism. You are supposed to dive into nature, contribute to ecological conservation, and improve the well-being of the local population. Eco-tourism essentially requires places that are rich in biodiversity, like forests or oceans, mountains. So what better place to start then than the Maldives? We're leaving you with this special report. Thanks very much for watching.
Welcome to paradise, while it still lasts. These are the islands of the Maldives, surrounded by blue seas and populated by warm people. On average, these islands are 1 meter above sea level, so the rising seas are an existential threat here. As the salt water creeps up, uncontaminated fresh water is disappearing. Like many islands in this part of the world, the Maldives is dependent on tourism. No wonder hoteliers here are looking to adapt. They are contributing to the climate fight. How? Through ecotourism.
36 years ago, Villa Hotels and Resorts was founded as with an idea of sustainability in mind. And today we are very proud to lead the way in maintaining and in promoting sustainability, conservation, preservation.
Villa Hotels is a pioneer in ecotourism. The freshest ingredients, zero food miles, and no plastic.
At our zero restaurant, guests are able to choose organic produce from our local farm, have it prepared by a professional chef, and enjoy it immediately.
Even the rooms are fully sustainable. The complimentary bottles here are made from glass. Plus, they are recycled on site.
Here at the bottling plant, we prepare over 2,000 bottles a day to be distributed to our rooms, facilities and island views. By doing so, we drastically reduce the need for plastic bottles on the island.
One of the biggest attractions in the Maldives are these underwater marvels, the coral reefs. When ocean temperatures rise, corals release their symbiotic algae that supply nutrients and impart its vibrant colors. That's a lot of science, but simply put, it looks something like this. South Asia Bureau, WION, World is One.
There are many other...
This is right, Arab.